Good day to everyone. So in the last video we have seen the different types of input and output statements, how to declare the constants, variables and everything. So in this video I am going to give the introduction about the initialization of variables and constants. So why the initialization is important in a program, in a Fortran program. I will start this with a simple example, the first program. This is the program where I have just started the program and declared that this I, the variable I, is a integer, and then I simply write the I value and the end the program. So this is my program, and I want to know what is the output. So if I'm not giving any values to the value I, the variable I, I want to find out what is the output. Initially I don't know what this output is, because it may be a 0 or any arbitrary number or any other previous values which is assigned for the value for the variable I. So this may be a possibility of the different outputs. So I want to find out what is the output, so I'm going to run the program. For example, so I have just used this program, in the same program I return here, and I'm going to run the program. It shows you the output as this is the output it is actually given. But this is not actually a given number. It is not the value I have expected. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run the program again. You can see that without the initialization, the Fortran compiler itself actually assigning the variable, any value to the integer I. Suppose if I run the program again, you can see that the value of the I is actually changed. So initially it's actually the number, but now it is a different number. You can see that it is 32594, but if I run the program once again, it will give you the another number. So it randomly giving the numbers if you are not initialize the program, any value to the particular variable. So this initialization is very important, otherwise our compiler itself, some compilers will consider this as a zero, or some latest compilers or latest programming versions will give you the different arbitrary numbers, or sometimes the previous values of the variable I. So what I have to do is I have to properly initialize the values to the corresponding variable. So I have started the program and declared the variable. Now I initialize that I is equal to 1 in the program itself. So if I write the program where value of the variable, then it will show you the corresponding correct result. For example, if I go to the program again and I'm going to edit that, I'm going to stop this one, and I'm going to initialize that which I is equal to 1, and then I'm going to run the program. So now this program will correctly give the results that the value of I is equal to 1. So whatever value I have given here will be displayed in the output itself. So the initialization is very important. So without the initialization, the value of the variable will be defined by the compiler itself with any arbitrary number. Suppose if you are using this variable for any further mathematical calculation, then you will end up with the wrong results. Okay, fine. So if you want to initialize the different variables, and if you want to declare the different types of statements, different types of numbers, from integer to logical or character value. So we already told you that the Fortran programming having its default statement, that is, if you are not mentioning any if you are not declaring any data type explicitly, then it automatically take I, J, K, L, M and N values, the variables which is starting with this alphabet taken as a integer values, and all the other variables which is starting with the letters A to H and O to Z will be taken as a real values or real number, real type. So if you want to do the, if you want to avoid this kind of situation where you have to explicitly give the values or the type of the different variables. Suppose if you want to avoid this situation, avoid this default method, then you have to use the command called implicit none. That means you are going to implicitly giving the, I mean, you are not giving any explicit default type. So the implicit attribute gives you the, that there is no default procedure can be should be followed in the Fortran program. So the implicit none means you are not actually explicitly, you are going to explicitly give all the types of the variables in the program itself by the user itself. Okay, so this is a one of the statement. You can also use the implicit with the different kinds. That means if I want to again consider this implicit as a double precision, for example, the letters which is start, the variables which is starting with the letters A to H and O to Z will be taken as a double precision numbers. That means it's one of the float, I mean, real numbers, but it takes a accurate decimal values. That means up to 16 bits or something. So if you want to use this kind of numbers, double precision numbers, then you can implicitly give that the variables which is starting with the letters with the alphabets A to H and O to Z will be taken as a double precision numbers. The remaining letters again I, J, K, L and M and N will be taken as a integer numbers again constantly. Otherwise you can just keep whatever the letters you want to use, you can use it here. Otherwise if you want to use all the values as integers, then you can put A to Z, all the variable names which is starting with the letters A to Z taken as an integer value, or you can put it as a real or whatever it is. So depending upon the user, depending upon the usage of your program, you can specify the types with the implicit command. So this is the important command, why we have to use the implicit program or implicit counter attribute in your program. I start with the one example where I have started the program and I have mentioned that the variable time is actually a real type, and I have given the value as 10. So that I have assigned the value of 10 to the variable time, which is having a type of real, and I am going to write the what is the value of time. So while writing the time, I have a small spelling mistake. That means instead of I am going to write is time, I write as a time. That is a careless mistake. I have just written as a time, and I end the program, run the program. You can see that the Fortran compiler will give you the any random number, a random number to the corresponding variable. What I mentioned is that 10 is the expected value which will be printed here, but due to the spelling mistake, that means the time is actually different from the time. So the compiler is seeing this variable, these two variables as entirely different one. So it assigned the different value to the another variable time. So it will do the, means it will show you the error or different wrong answer. So to avoiding this kind of situations or this kind of mistakes, again you have to use the implicit none. So I will just explain the same example with the implicit none command. Again the same 10 value, number 10, and I have again done the same mistake and in the program, run the program. So while running the program, you can see that this program is this time is actually explicitly explicitly declared as a real constant or real variable, but this time variable is not actually declared anywhere in the program. So while compiling the compiler itself actually find that the time is not actually a implicit type, so that you will not get the you will not get the wrong result, but instead of that the program itself showing the syntax error, this variable is not declared implicitly. So that this is one of the very important aspects in the program. You have to mention the variable with the correct type of the statement, and then you have to use the implicit none. If you are using the implicit none or implicit attribute, then you can easily identify the this kind of mistakes in your program. Okay, fine. So next is the what I am going to do explain is the intrinsic functions, which we already seen in the last video with the some of the intrinsic functions we have already seen in the last video, just light, cos and sine, everything. So the intrinsic function means besides the simple regular arithmetic operations, a number of useful built-in functions which is already available in the Fortran, that is called the intrinsic functions. The I have given some list of intrinsic functions here, and the what are the function variable in the what is the value of the function in the left or right column. So you can see that you can easily calculate the square root of the x value by any other number using the format sqrt in open and close parenthesis. You can give the x. That means usually the intrinsic function having the function name with the corresponding variable name or a variable value. You can easily give the either it's a variable variable, or you can give the directly give the value of that corresponding function. So if you use the square sqrt of x, then it will actually find out the square root of the corresponding given variable name. Similarly, we can also find the absolute value of the any number using the intrinsic function abs x. Similarly, if you want to find out the integer of absolute value, similarly you can do that with the iabs function. Again, the trigonometry function sine, cos, tan and everything, you can even the exponential function, logarithmic, natural logarithmic and the log base 10 and integer and near integer real. This near integer we already see in this near integer and real we have already seen in the last video itself. I will tell you what it is. And one more thing is you have to be very careful about writing the trigonometric functions. Whatever you are giving the variable name should be in terms of the radians. Suppose if you are giving the value of the x value in terms of theta degrees, then this value is actually the whatever the value given to the x value will be taken as a radians, then it will calculate the cos value. So suppose if you are expecting the value of cos of something with the degrees, then you will end up with the wrong result or a mismatched result. So what is actually done is whatever you have given as a degrees, which actually converted into the radians, then it the cos value is actually calculated. So suppose if you want to use the intrinsic functions with the trigonometric expressions, then you have to convert the corresponding value x value into the radians. I hope you everyone know the how to convert the theta means degree into radians. I will explain it later. Similarly, you can easily find out the exponential, that means e power minus x or e power plus x. You can give it the value of minus or plus, you can give it so that it is whether it's exponentially decaying or it's exponentially increasing, which you can easily find out using the expression exp of x. Similarly, the natural logarithm can be done with the log of x, and the log base 10 can be done with the log 10x. And if you want to convert the any value into the integer value, then you can use the intrinsic function int x. Similarly, if you have any real number which you should convert into the nearest integer value, then you can use the int x intrinsic function. Similarly, any integer values can be converted into the real value. You can use it with the real I. Similarly, you have a mod function, and suppose if you have any two different numbers, and if you want to find out which is the maxima of that between the two numbers, then you can use max of AB. This is not a function here. And similarly, you can use the minimum. Suppose if you have two numbers, if you want to find out the minimum number, the smallest number between the two numbers, then you can use the intrinsic function M of A comma B. You can use only with the two numbers. Similarly, the trigonometry functions is sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse, and the hyperbolic functions sin h and cos h can be done with the means which is available. The intrinsic functions are available to calculate the corresponding values or trigonometric values of the corresponding given number. Again, you have to give the x value as a radians. So you know that if you want to convert the radians in degree into radians, you have to use the degree which is equal to pi times of radians. So if you want to suppose if you are actually giving the value in terms of degrees, So you can, the program itself, you can convert it with the radians. For example, the y is equal to sine of something. That means that the theta value given in the degree, which can be converted with a pi divided by 180, so that this pi divided by 180 will be multiplied with the corresponding theta value in term which is in terms of degrees, then converted into the radians, then the sine value will be calculated, so that you will get the exact y value in terms of radians. This you can do it in the intrinsic program. Okay, so I hope you just remember this intrinsic functions, so that you can use it in the regular mathematical operations. So I'm going to give you some of the examples for the intrinsic functions where we have using. So I'm going to give some mathematical expressions as an example, and the its equivalent, Fortran equivalent versions. So suppose if I using alpha divided by square root of alpha square plus omega squared and cos of omega 2 omega t plus 5. So you can convert this mathematical expression into program, the Fortran programming equivalent, with the A1. That means I can take this AL as a alpha, and you can just declare the AL is alpha is equal to AL and omega is equal to OM. Similarly, the phi can be taken as a phi phi. So you just declare the variables as it is, and then you can use it in the program command. That means cos of OM into T, that means omega into T plus phi divided by square root of alpha squared plus omega squared. So squared, you can use it with the power, the double asterisk. Similarly, this expression log of the natural logarithm of E log E square root of X divided by Y Z can be converted as like this. And the other mathematical expressions also can be converted in this side of the, in this kind of expressions, in the Fortran equivalent expressions. So you just be comfortable with the converting the mathematical expression into Fortran equivalent. I will give you the assignment for this one. Okay, so okay, maybe we can stop with here with the comments which we have made. We have seen the how to initialize the variables and some of the intrinsic functions. And so here I am going to give you some of the examples of the programs where we can just familiar with the programs with the different problems. So the first problem, the first example is you have to convert the degrees which are given to the U into the Fahrenheit to the Kelvin. Usually we done with the degree centigrade to Kelvin, degree centigrade to Fahrenheit. Here you have a formula for converting the temperature from Fahrenheit to Kelvin. This is the formula. That means phi divided by 9 times of the Fahrenheit, whatever it is given, minus 32 into plus 273.15. So this is the formula to convert the Fahrenheit to Kelvin. So you have to use this formula, then you have to get the inputs, that means the Fahrenheit terms, the temperature from the user, and you can have to convert the temperature from Fahrenheit to Kelvin. So using this formula, so for this I am going to start the program with the program name, and I have used the implicit none attribute here. Then I declared the values Fahrenheit as Kelvin variables as a real type, and I am asking the user to enter the value of the temperature in terms of Fahrenheit. So the whatever the value given will be saved in the variable Fahrenheit. Then I am going to convert the, it means I am going to give the expression Kelvin, which is equal to phi divided by 9 into the Fahrenheit, whatever the variable given, the value given by the user, minus 32 and plus 273.15. So once we done that, and then you can write the output, the Fahrenheit degree, whatever the, you can just directly run it, you can directly give the values, or you can write whatever you require, then you can give the output. So if I run the program, then I give the values as minus 110 degrees of Fahrenheit. This degree Fahrenheit is actually converted into the 194.26 kelvins. So this simple program will actually convert the Fahrenheit to kelvins. So this is the one of the simplest program where we have used the implicit none, and you can see that the mathematical operations you are using is actually, we already told you that how to give the expression in terms of mathematical operations, the mathematical operation into Fortran programming commands. You can use the parenthesis and multiply to all the other arithmetic and logic arithmetic operations correctly. Okay, so the another example is you have to simplest for a problem is find out the time period of the simple pendulum. Suppose if you know the formula of any of the physical situation, then you can easily apply the this convert this formula into mathematical expression to the photon. That means you know that t is equal to 2 pi by square root of L divided by G. So this is the formula to find out the time period of the simple pendulum. So once if you know the value of L and G is a constant, so only if you know the value of L, the length of the pendulum, then you can find out the what is the temperature, I mean the time period, sorry. So here you can see that you have a two different constants. One is the pi and another one is the acceleration due to gravity, the value of G. So you have to mention this, I mean you have to declare the constants in the initial, I mean initial of the initialization of the program. So I have started the program and the implicit none, and I have used the parameter attribute to declare the two constant values pi and G. Okay, so the pi value is 3.141593. So usually we will give the pi value as 3.14, but usually if you write the program and if you want to declare the constants, you have to give the numbers as accurate as possible so that you can get the very accurate output. So that I have used the pi as 3.141593 and the G is actually declared as a 9.81, which is a constant. Okay, so you can use the parameter attribute to declare the constants, and I am declared the real as means the LTD, I mean the length of the pendulum, which is I am going to get it from the user, and the time period which I have taken as a variable t, and d is the which I had to use it for the different other purpose here. So I get the values of L and T, L from the user, that means the length of the pendulum. The user enter the length of the pendulum, then you can calculate the time period using the same formula. Just I convert this formula into the Fortran code, that we see is equal to 2 asterisk into pi into square root of the bracket L by G. Here I have used the intrinsic function, the square root. Okay, so once I have this done, then the time period will be calculated. And what I am going to do is I am going to convert the degrees, this the angular displacement of the pendulum in terms of degrees, so that I have to convert this into the radians, then I can use the, I mean I can find out the what is the sine value. So I have just simple write the simple script, enter the value of D, that means in terms of degrees. So whatever the values given by the user will be converted into the radians. This radians will be taken as a variable DR, and then it is actually the converted degree radians value will be used in the sine value, so that you will get the correct value of the x value. So I just written the, I mean run the program. So you have to give the length of the pendulum. I have given the value as 3, so it actually calculated the time period as 3.474 something, and I have included the degree as 15 degrees. This 15 degrees is actually converted into the radians. This is nothing but the 0.26 one something, 0.6261, and then the sine value of this is actually calculated using the intrinsic function, and this is the corresponding value. So this is one of the simplest program to find out the time period of the pendulum and converting the degree into radians and using it in the trigonometric functions. And so I have to give the another one example. Suppose if I have a and b, which are the two sides of the triangle, and theta is the angle included by these sides. Suppose if I have any area A, B, and this is the theta I have given, so I have find out what is the corresponding the other side, I have to find out the length of the third side and area of the triangle, the total area of the triangle you have to calculate. So if you know the formula for this calculation, then you can easily convert this into the programming code. So for example, if you want to find out the length of the other side, length of the third side, so you can use the formula, which is something which is equal to square root of a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. So this is the formula to find out the length. Similarly, the area can be find out, I mean area can be a d sine of theta divided by 2. So these are the two formulas to find out the length of the bend, length of the other side, and this is for the area. The A is equal to AB by, or AB is taken as a area, which is equal to AB sine theta divided by 2. So I can just convert this values into the mathematical operator with the Fortran codes, this one and this one, so that you can easily find getting the value of AB. We already know the values of A and B, and you can find out the what is the other side, maybe C. Okay, this is the program to calculate the triangle, the length and area. So again, the implicit none, and I'm going to declare the variables as real again, and I'm going to get the values of A, B and theta, that means the two sides and the theta value. Then I have again converting the theta in term, the theta is in terms of degrees, I'm going to convert into the radians. Okay, then I can use it for the square root of A squared plus B squared minus 2AB cos of this radians theta. So I can get the value. Similarly, I have used 1 by 2 as a 0.5 for some for the simplify the Fortran code. I have used the 0.5 multiplied by the AB sine of theta. So I can calculate the area, then you can print the value as C and area. So the output is, suppose if I input the values of A value is 2.4, B value is 6.5, and the theta in terms of degree is 35 degree, then I can find out the other side of length of the other side and the area, total area of the total area of the triangle. So this is another simple example. So these are all the very simple examples where you can just, the flow of the Fortran program is actually going from upside down, and every instruction is converted to the line by line conversion. And okay, suppose if I run the programs and everything, I wrote the program and everything is okay, but usually if you are doing a program or writing a program, this the program will not always give you the correct results. That means sometimes if you make any errors, the program will not give you the correct answers, that will show you the error. So how to debug the program? That means there are the different simple techniques to write the good program. So usually even the professional programmers, the program won't work at the first time itself, because sometimes they may maybe do some silly mistakes, maybe in terms of syntax error or some other mathematical errors. So usually the program will not first at the first run itself. So if in that case we have to use, we have to do the debugging. Suppose the program is very simplest program, then the debugging is very simple. Or if the program is having some thousand lines or something, then the debugging will be very complex. So usually this Fortran will show you, any program will show you the three different types of errors. One is the syntax error, and another one is the runtime error, the next one is the logical error. So these are all the three common, the three errors in the Fortran, in any programming language you come up with. Okay, so usually the syntax error is nothing but the Fortran statement error. That means, so suppose if you are wrongly mentioning the syntax, for example, I told you that some read, and if you are giving asterisk, forgetting the comma, then if you are running the program, then the program will say you that while compiling itself is showing that this the syntax is not right to do the corresponding instruction. So the program will, the compiler will find the error mistake, and you can rectify or debug the corresponding error just by doing this. So apart from this, you have another two errors, the runtime error and logical error. The compiler will not find these mistakes, the runtime error is usually done, occurred because of the illegal mathematical operations while doing the mathematical, while executing the mathematical operations. And the logical error is another error where the program compile and run the program successfully, but it will give you the output as wrong output. In that case, that is a logical error. That means you don't have any syntax error, and you give the mathematical expression, everything is correctly, but sometimes due to any small mistake in the mathematical expression, then because of you forgetting to mention the open parenthesis or any division mistakes, then it will show you it will run the program, but it will show you the different wrong answer, the answer which is not expected. So that is called a logical error. So if you are usually if you are running the program, you come up with you facing these kind of errors, syntax error and runtime error and sometimes the logical error. So if you want to avoid these kind of mistakes, you have to follow some simple techniques. That means suppose if you are using the very long mathematical expressions, you can just split it into the different statements, or if you are using the long assignment statements, then you can split it with the some you can break it into small statements. And again, you can use the if you want to avoid the runtime error and logical error, you can just find out, check the placement of the parentheses. Suppose if you are mentioning this as a plus b the whole square by 2, you can write it as sometimes you can write a plus b and divided by 2 the whole square. If you are putting the parentheses as a different, then it will give you the different answer or a wrong answer. What I'm expected is a plus b the whole square divided by 2. But what you have done in the program is a plus b by 2 divided the whole square. So this will give you the different answer or wrong answer. So we have to be careful about the placement of the parentheses and the mathematical expressions. Similarly, you have to initialize all the variables and constants. This is very important. Without that, sometimes if you are not initializing any variables, then the compiler itself initialize the program with any variable with any wrong random number, then the expected results will not come. Okay, and again the intrinsic functions you are using in with the correct units, maybe in terms of theta or degree or radians, theta in terms of degree or radians, or suppose if you have a program mathematical a physical example, suppose if you want to find out the velocity but the user is actually given the distance in terms of centimeters, but you have considered it as a meter and then you have just included it everything in the calculation. So this kind of errors you have to avoid. Again, the very important thing is a mixed mode arithmetic. This is a very important one again. Suppose if you are using the mixed mode arithmetic, that means using different integer or real type doing the mathematical arithmetic operations, then the result is maybe in terms of integer or real, that you have to be careful about it. Suppose if you are avoiding this all these mistakes, suppose still the program is not working, so you have to debug the program line by line. So how to do that is, suppose if you are reading the numbers from the user and you can make sure that the readed value is correct or not, so that you can just simply use the write statement to write the value. For example, this program, I am getting the values of a, b and theta from the user, so you can just write the statement here, write a, b and theta. Then whatever the value is getting from the input will mean as an input will be actually printed in the terminal, so that you can make sure that these values are correctly readed by the computer. Similarly, if you do any mathematical operation, if anything is wrong with this mathematical step, you can just write the statement here and you can find out the value of what is the radians of theta or whatever the results, so that use the write statement to get the you can line by line you check the this program and find out the mistake. Okay, probably I stop here and I will explain the somewhat advanced statements in the next class. I hope you have a many things. The video is actually understandable to you. That's a very simple operation, intrinsic functions that we have just explained. Suppose if you have any doubts, then we can again, as usual, we discuss in the online class. Thank you.